Now is the time to give your heart. Come, just as you are, to worship. Come, just as you are before.
Welcome to today's worship experience. A special welcome goes out to the St. Andrew Scots Kirk family, as well as to all our visiting friends who are worshiping with us today. The presence of God is with us, whether we are here in Jamaica or in other parts of the world. So please open your heart unto Him and receive the blessing that is in store. Welcome. Let us continue to worship Almighty God as we sing the songs. I will enter into His gates with thanksgiving in my heart, after which we will slow it down with Abba Father.
For He has made me glad.
Let us share in the call to worship. We gather this day to celebrate life, the life we have been given by God, the life we share with one another in community, the life that Jesus gives in abundance.
Let us be grateful for the joy of life, and let us worship God.
Welcome this day to the house of our God. We are greeted in peace and in love.
Welcome this day to the worship of our Creator.
We worship in hope and with grace.
Welcome this day to our community of faith, where we are sisters and brothers in Christ.
Then let us worship God. Our opening hymn, Joyful, Joyful, We Adore Him.
Let us pray. Dear Lord and Heavenly Father, we thank you for the God that you are. We thank you and we praise you for your everlasting glory and goodness. You, O Lord, are the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. Lord, you have bestowed blessings upon our lives, countless, dear Lord, and for that we praise you. You, O Lord, in your infinite wisdom, gave us life, and you sent your Son to redeem your world that you created. Lord, we praise you and we adore you, dear Lord, for the amount of blessings that you have done in our lives. We praise you for the countless testimonies that we are able to share. We know that so many have been born and have not made it to see today. We praise you and we honor you that you are still here giving us your blessings when we know that we don't deserve them. And Lord, we know that your love is everlasting, has no boundaries. And so we thank you and we praise you and we adore you for giving us your unimaginable love. And we honor you for the goodness that you have done in our lives. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen.
with everything within me, I declare your glory.
Today is a day of praise and thanksgiving, and so even now, I invite all those who are present in their homes or wherever you are watching this video, to offer your own prayers of thanksgiving. Let us pray.
Today, I am thanking God for health and for providing food on my table.
Today, I am giving thanks for life, and I'm giving thanks for family. In Jesus' name, amen. We will now sing the chorus, "When the praises go up, the blessings come down."
Good to see you. God bless you. Amen.
When the praises go up, the blessings come down. Come on, worship the Lord. Hallelujah. When the praises go up,
when the praises go up,
then the blessings come down.
The blessings come down.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
When the praises go up,
Our Father,
who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
One, for each blessed day. Two, every breath I take. Three, for my family. Four, all they mean to me. Five, just to be alive. Six, for the earth and sky. And seven, for heaven. For every good thing that I have comes from God. Every day, every hour, there are blessings He sends without number or end.
By the rivers of Babylon, there we were. There we sat down. Yea, we wept when we remembered Zion. We hung our harps upon the willows in the midst thereof. For there they that carries us away captive required of us a song. And they that wasted us required of a mirth of us mirth, saying, sing us one of the songs of Zion. How shall we sing the Lord's song in a strange land? If I forget thee, O Jerusalem, let my right hand forget her cunning. If I do not remember thee, let my tongue cleave to the roof of my mouth. If I prefer not Jerusalem above my chief joy. Remember, O Lord, the children of Edom in the day of Jerusalem, the foundation thereof, O daughter of Babylon, how art to be destroyed? Happy shall he be that rewardeth thee as thou hast served us. Happy shall he be that taketh and dasheth thy little ones against the stones. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Oh.
Almighty God, may you speak to the hearts of your people so that they may be encouraged, so that they may be challenged. This we pray in Jesus' holy name. Amen and amen. Life is made up of varying experiences, the good, the bad, and the in-between. Life is made up of the mountaintop experiences, but it also has some valley experiences. And whilst it can be beautiful whilst on the mountaintop, it can be very trying or overwhelming whilst going through the valley. Psalm 137 was definitely a valley experience for the people of Israel. This psalm is indeed a difficult text that deals with some difficult themes that will require a wider reading of scripture to understand its true context. But what jumps out is that the Israelites here were taken into captivity from Judea into Babylon. And to make matters worse, they were being insulted by their oppressors who wanted them to entertain them by singing a song of Zion. The songs of Zion were the songs that they sung to their God. They were in fact mocking their faith. Psalm 137 is indeed a mournful psalm, a song of lament. The people, no doubt, would have been feeling downtrodden or defeated as they endured oppression from their proud oppressors. Perhaps most of us hearing this message might not know firsthand what it is like to be captured from one's homeland and to be prisoners in a foreign land. We can only imagine how difficult it would have been for these people to enjoy themselves under such oppressive conditions. This text presents them by the rivers of Babylon in a strange land, away from their homeland. They were basically prisoners of war. Babylon was now a land and a place of bondage for the people of Israel. As they sat down by the rivers, they wept. The immense rivers of Babylon reminded them that they were no longer in their own homeland. It is not hard then to believe, along with David Guzik, that they wept over the death of so many loved ones, that they wept over the loss of almost everything they owned, that they wept over the destroyed city of Jerusalem and her great temple, that they wept over the agony of a forced march from Judea to Babylon, that they wept over the cruelty of their present situation, that they wept over the bleak nature of their future, that they wept over their sin that invited such judgment from their God. The Israelites here hung up their harps on the willow trees that were along the rivers because they would not sing the Lord's song in this strange land as their oppressors sought to mock their faith. But the godly could not forget Jerusalem and everything that it stood for. They vowed never to forget God's promises and were resolute in waiting for the day of deliverance. Did they forget the songs of Zion? I think not, and neither should we. Not only will we not forget our songs of praise, but also we will sing our songs of praise even while we go through this valley experience. For as we sing our songs of praise, and in praising God, we will praise our way out of our valleys. Hallelujah. We can be assured of deliverance because the psalmist reminds us in Psalm 34:19, many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord delivers him out of them all. Hallelujah. Also, Isaiah 43:2 tells us that when you pass through the waters, I will be with you, and through the rivers, they shall not overflow you. When you walk through the fire, you shall not be burned, nor shall the flame scorch you. The enemy expects us to be depressed and oppressed because of our present situation, a situation so removed from that which is in keeping with our former normal that it now feels as though we are in a strange land. But I want to encourage the people of God that now is a time for us to praise our way out of this mess. We are not the people of God for nothing. We are a people of praise. We are a people of hope. Those who do not yet know the Lord Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior of their lives may not understand this hope that we have. This hope that we have is in Christ Jesus, and our hope is real. It is not a make-believe hope. You can have this hope too if you are willing to surrender your life unto Jesus Christ. All that is required is for you to recognize and confess that you are a sinner in need of forgiveness and to invite Christ into your life. Yes, the enemy expects us to be in a defeatist mindset on account of the negative effects that this COVID-19 is having on our lives and on the lives of our family members and friends. But I want to remind us this morning, my brothers and sisters, as is said in Psalm 31:1, I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. My brothers and sisters, anybody can praise God when they're on the mountaintop. Anybody can praise God when their sickness has been healed. Anybody can praise God when their businesses or job is booming. But it takes something more to praise God when you are down in the valley. But it takes something more to praise God when the world is under the throes of COVID-19. When people are dying left, right, and center. But it takes something more to praise God when your business is under pressure. And it seems that at any moment now, you might have to close its doors. My brothers and sisters, I have good news for you today. We don't have to wait until after COVID-19 to start praising God. Hallelujah. We can start our praise now. We can praise God now, even whilst we might be between that rock and a hard place. We don't have to wait until after COVID-19 to praise God. We can praise God exactly where we are, in this moment, in this strange land, and God will lift us up. We don't have to wait until all our tears are dried. Let us praise him through our tears and praise our way out of whatever situation we find ourselves. Now is a time for us to praise our way out, and let us be encouraged knowing that God hears our praises, and as the praises go up, the blessings will come down. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. and amen.
Seal it for thy God.
This is a table of our Lord Jesus Christ. He invites all those who are his and are in right relationship with him to partake in this, his memorial meal. As we draw nigh unto the table of our Lord Jesus Christ, let us spend a moment in confession. Let us pray. Holy and righteous God, as we pause in your presence now, Lord, we come confessing our sins. We recognize that so many times we have failed you. There have been times, Lord God, when you instructed us to act in a particular way, and we failed to do so. We went ahead and did what we thought should have been done. There are other times, Lord God, when you instructed us not to do, but we did as we please. Lord, forgive us. And for the times, Lord, when we unknowingly went against your will, we pray that you will forgive us. Lord, whatever is within us that is not of you, we pray that you will cleanse us, that you will wash us, that you will purge us, Lord God. Not just a surface cleansing, but that you will purge us from deep within. That, Lord, we may not sit at your table unworthily, but that, Lord, your righteousness will make us worthy to partake in this, your memorial meal. For we pour out our all before you, hiding nothing of ourselves, but presenting our very hearts. Thank you for your forgiveness, for we pray in Jesus' holy name. And the people of God say,
Amen.
Let us hear again the narrative of the institution of the Lord's Supper, as it is recorded by the Apostle Paul. The tradition which I handed on to you came to me from the Lord himself, that on the night of his arrest, the Lord Jesus took bread, and after giving thanks to God, broke it and said, This is my body, which is for you. Do this in memory of me. In the same way, he took the cup after supper and said, This cup is a new covenant sealed by my blood. Whenever you drink it, do so in memory of me. For every time you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the death of the Lord until he comes. As the Lord Jesus, the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread, I take these elements of bread and wine to be set apart from all common uses, to this holy use and mystery. And as he gave thanks and blessed, let us draw near to God and offer him our prayers of thanksgiving. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
Almighty God, we give you thanks for these common elements of bread and wine. We pray, O God, that your Holy Spirit will fall upon them, and that your Spirit will bless them, will consecrate them, Lord God, so that as your people partake of them, they will truly represent for us your body and blood, broken and shed on Calvary's cross, that we may be saved from all our sins. Bless them, we pray, in Jesus' holy name. Amen and amen. According to the holy institution, example, and command of our Lord Jesus Christ, and as a memorial of him, we do this. Who, on the night when he was betrayed, took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, This is my body, which is broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same way, he took the cup, saying, This cup is a new covenant sealed by my blood. Whenever you drink it, do so in memory of me. Jesus, Lamb of God,
have mercy on us.
Jesus, bearer of our sins,
have mercy on us.
Jesus, redeemer of the world,
grant us thy peace.
The body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ for the people of God. This bread represents the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, broken on Calvary's cross for the remission of all our sins. Let us eat it and be thankful. So too, this cup represents the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. Let us drink of it and be thankful. Let us give thanks. Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us at your table. Lord, as we partake, may your body and blood refresh us, renew us, and re-energize us, so that as we go out into the world during this week and beyond, we will be your true disciples, your true representatives to the world. We give you thanks for feeding us at your table, and we say thanks in Jesus' holy name. And the people of God say,
amen
and amen. Let us offer our prayers of intercession before Almighty God. Compassionate God and Father, we acknowledge that you are present with all your people everywhere. We pray at this time for all persons who are affected by COVID-19. For the families who have lost loved ones, we pray, O God, that you will strengthen them in their time of mourning. For those, Lord God, who have lost their jobs, their businesses, we pray, Lord, that you will open new avenues for them. For those who have insufficient food at this time, we pray, Lord, that you will open the hearts of those who have food, that we will share with them, O God. We pray, Lord God, for those who are sick and those who are anxious at this time. May you be a real sense of peace in their lives. For those, oh God, who do not know how to approach the future, we pray, Lord, that you will help them to realize that you are with them and that with you all things are possible. We pray, Lord, even for our own country, Jamaica, land we love. We pray for our leaders, our prime minister, opposition leaders, counselors, members of parliament. We pray, Lord, for our schools, teachers, principals. We pray, Lord, that wisdom will be granted to all who lead. We pray, Lord God, for our churches who continue to provide a light and a hope in this challenging time. We pray, Lord God, that our light will burn brightly and that in spite of all that is taking place, we will not be daunted, but that we will stand firmly in you. We pray, Lord God, for all our members who are grieving because they have lost loved ones, our loved ones who have been affected by this terrible virus. We pray, God, that you continue to surround them with your love and your real presence. We pray for our sick and shut-ins, Lord. We pray that you continue to remind them that you are with them. For those who are in need in other ways that we have not named, we pray, oh God, that you will fulfill every need. Whatever we fail to ask, we ask that you fail not to grant. For we ask all these in Jesus' name. Amen and amen.
Bless.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul. Worship His holy name. Sing like never before, oh my soul. I worship Your holy name. The sun comes up, it's a new day dawning. It's time to sing Your song again. Whatever may pass and whatever lies before me, let me be singing when the evening comes. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul. Worship His holy name. Your holy name. You're rich in love and You're slow to anger. Your name is great and Your heart is kind. For all Your goodness I will keep on singing. 10,000 reasons for my heart to find. So bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul. Worship His holy name. Sing like worship Your holy name. Bless You, time has come. Still my soul will sing Your praise unending. 10,000 years and then forevermore, forevermore. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul. Worship His holy name. Sing like never before, oh my soul. I worship Your holy name. Come on, bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul. Worship His holy. Worship Your holy name. Lord, I worship Your holy name. Sing like never before, oh my soul. Worship Your holy name, Jesus.
worship your holy name.
Let us receive the benediction. May the blessings of the one who is the way be with you in the days to come. God, guide our feet wherever we go. May the blessings of Jesus, who is our life, be with you in the days to come. May he lead us by the hand to those who are our sisters and brothers in need. May the blessings of the Spirit of Truth be with you in the days to come. May we journey with the Spirit to that way which is everlasting. Amen and amen.